Saddle up your horses.
Friday, and we've just come from Barstow. We've stopped here on our first trip to Afton Canyon to go do some rock collecting and sightseeing. Afton Canyon is known as the Grand Canyon of the Mojave, and it is one of three places along the Mojave River where there is year-round surface flow. The canyon is located 35 miles east of Barstow, approximately 3.5 miles south of I-15 at the Afton Canyon off-ramp. Afton Canyon is mentioned in several rock collecting guidebooks, and the material at this site consists of red and yellow jasper, agate, opalite in pastel shades of pink and pistachio green, and occasional calcite. Here we are in the Lake Mead National Recreation Area, and we have gone traveling on some road, and we've ended up at a slot canyon. It's pretty cool. We're in the middle of nowhere though.
Right here.
here we are in Cedar City at the Motel 6 in the morning after we've arrived, and oh my gosh, look at the snow. It's pretty covered.
Down.
Pretty wet.
Heck.
Here we are in the scenic overlook just northeast of Escalante. Beautiful out here. Calf Creek Falls is one of the most well-known features in Grand Staircase Escalante National Monument, and is one of the monument's most popular trails. Several Anasazi ruins and some large pictographs can be seen along this easy 5.5 mile round-trip hike. During the summer months, I'm sure this trail crawls with other visitors, but on a day like today, where the temperature was approximately 34 degrees, we only ran into 3 or 4 other hikers on this entire trip. Quite a luxury. Mini Dog really enjoyed being off leash during this hike. Calf Creek got its name from early pioneers who used the Box Canyon as a natural pasture in which to store weaned calves. Water flows in Calf Creek year-round and cascades 126 feet down a sheer sandstone cliff. The deep pool beneath the falls is surrounded by lush vegetation. Navajo sandstone is the predominant geologic layer found in Calf Creek Canyon, and is a hard, cliff-forming layer, usually white in color. The dark streaks on the canyon walls are called desert varnish. It forms when rainwater runs down a rock surface. As the water evaporates, mineral precipitate, such as manganese, is left on the rock. Wind blowing across the rock polishes the color onto the surface. Over time, the process is repeated and the coloration becomes darker.
Well, the moon moved past Nebraskans, put a laughter on them cold Dakota hills. Angels danced on Jacob's stairs. Yeah, they danced on Jacob's stairs.
Here we are at the Dry Fork of the Coyote Gulch, at the trailhead, heading down into the slot canyons down below, which are down here in this area. Go, Minnie. Yep.
Wanna give me a camera?
Come on, Minnie. Let's go. Let's go. Holy cow. Go on, Minnie. Go, come on. Go, let's go. Go on, Minnie. Go on.
She won't go.
Oh my gosh. How am I gonna fit through there?
I don't know. Isn't that fascinating? A little lower, maybe. Long ways. See?
Yeah, oh wow. Keep going.
We are literally walking sideways. Ha ha!
Wow, this is really narrow.
Ah, finally, it's not right in turn. Oh my god. It could get worse, but I think it does. Dude! It's a literally 1 foot at a time.
Wow.
Nisha needs some help. Don't let her back out.
Okay.
Come on, Pop! Come up! Come on, Minnie! Up! Minnie, up! Minnie, up! Yeah.
I've got her. She can't get around me. All
right. Come here, Minnie. Come on. Come on. Come here. I'm going to have to pick her up.
Okay.
Is this spooky?
Yeah.
It is spooky. It is dark in here.
You'd be dead if there was a flashlight, you know that?
Yeah, I don't see that.
That's where we walked through, all that water. That narrow canyon wall. We're waiting for the sun. I don't think it's gonna come though. Where's Dean? Where's the mini dog? There she is. There she is! Oh, Minnie! Minnie's not having a good time at all. She's wishing we were at home.
There's my sweetheart. Still down in the crevice.
With scared little wet doggy.
Poor little doggy's terrified. She's shaking. That was a very grueling experience coming through this crack. I didn't tape any of it because it was just too difficult to tape. Could barely even squeeze through there. Come on, Minnie, come on, let's go, let's go. Come on. Come on, doggy.
Fire up.
Just came from there. Can't see around the corner.
There's a big yucky puddle around the corner.
And here we go around this corner. Oh man.
Happy
to be done with this anytime.
Come on, doggy. The boulders are massive right here. Man, you really strain your body doing this.
Yep. We're almost out of the canyon. We just come from this dark hole down here. There's the rock Connie just climbed over. Here is the hole we just came out from. Done with the hard part.
Can I hold Minnie? Yeah, this is neat. Looks like
Still very narrow. Ouch.
Yeah, it's a little sideways. Good girl.
Wow, that's cool.
Yeah, that is cool.
Come on, doggy.
To be in the light.
Yeah.
Hi, Minnie. We carried too much stuff down here.
Oh, it's all open. There's a wash. Okay, we're almost back to the truck. It's up there. But we're going to stop off and see this last slot canyon before we go.
Here she comes. Her little feet. We probably could keep going.
All right, well, you want
to
trudge through the mud? I will if you will. It's pretty muddy.
Look at her poor feet.
Look at my poor feet.
Yeah, they're pretty bad.
Suction, mud suction. Yuck. Well, that's as far as I can see. The mud stopped us. We're not doing it. This is too gross. Too goopy. That's yucky.
I'd love to get our footprints coming down that, but it's too far away.
Yeah. There's where we've been. Up there. There's Peekaboo, which we didn't get to go on because it was too muddy. But that's okay. It's been a fine day, but we were beat. Really tired. It's a lot of hiking. Here we are, still in Escalante. It's the morning, we're leaving. This is a view from our bed and breakfast where we stayed. The Rainbow Country bed and breakfast. It's a very pleasant experience. Our host Catherine was very friendly. She allowed dogs, so Minnie had a good time playing with her dog. Here's the place. Little house under downstairs. It's really nice inside. Just turned off onto Skutumpah Road. And there's our sign. Miles to Kanab, Utah. We're in Sheep Creek now. We have to cross the creek. It's kind of frozen over. So we'll see how well we do.
Dean's gonna cross the icy creek. Oh, well that wasn't very challenging, was it? Frozen solid. Ice didn't even crack.
Well, we've driven straight up to the entrance of Willis Creek Canyon. We're certainly not going any further.
In the truck.
At least not in the truck. But we are definitely going to hike through that.
I swear she learned that from Grizzly.
Probably. That's the last we'll see of the truck for the rest of this hike. The creek is frozen solid. Getting a little bit too wet and a little bit too icy, so we're stopping here. The rest of it looks like it's the same. And we're going to turn around and go back.
Driving up Willis Creek. Driving down it, actually. Just finished.
Here we are now in Bull Valley Gorge, at the bottom of it. Driven in kind of in the tail end, but we can't continue any further. So we're gonna hike now.
This was the most exciting part, huh?
Yeah, the rest of it's all open and stuff.
The tree, I forgot about the tree.
Oh yeah.
That's neat. It's so snowy.
Here we are at Bull Valley Gorge. The bridge, actually. We were on the overpass, looking down into this crevice here. That's the upper part. There's the lower part. Pretty snowy up here. There's the gorge. And there's the bridge we just came over. Here we are on the Moquith Mountains trail, west of Kanab, and really close to the coral pink sand dunes. The trail is virgin snow, and it's quite fun so far.
This is how Mini Dog attacks trees.
Give it a mirror.
There she goes.
I can zoom on this. Some animal tracks ahead of us. Sure would like to see the animal.
Found ourselves a nice patch of slick rock on this trail. Dean's gonna come down. Pretty cold out here. Oh, piece of cake, look at that. No problemo. It's pretty steep a little further on. Don't know if we'll get any tires off the ground, but as you can see, it gets quite steep right there. I'm beginning to think we bought a Humvee because this truck is nearly unstoppable. Check that out.
Well, here we are. Forward progress has ceased up this little hill, and even with a locker, still couldn't make it up this little sandy part. It's pretty deep. So we're thinking about winching, looking up to this tree here. There's Minnie just waiting for us.
We're more than just a little stuck. You can see snow and sand up to the wheel wells. Very deep. But we decided to winch it. That tree. Oh, not that tree. That tree right there. So, Dean. There we are. Hooked up to the tree. We'll see what happens. Oh, I can hear it twanging. Not liking it. We're almost out. Boy, look at that hubcap. What hubcap?
Coral Pink Sand Dune State Park encompasses 3,700 acres of southwestern Utah, just 12 miles from US Highway 89 near Kanab. The dunes get their pinkish tint from the eroding Navajo sandstone formation surrounding the park, and the dunes themselves are created because the wind is funneled through a notch between the Moccasin and Moquith Mountains, thereby increasing wind velocity to a point where it can carry sand grains. This phenomenon is known as the Venturi effect. Once the wind passes through the notch and into the open valley, the wind velocity decreases, causing the sand to be deposited. Here we are on the Elephant Butte Trail, just south of the Coral Pink Sand Dune State Park. And we've got excellent views of Zion and the surrounding territory. It's beautiful out here. A little cold, but it's well worth it. There's Zion out there. Here we are now in the Calico Hills. This is the Doran Canyon Scenic Loop, and this is the trail we're about to go through. It's really rocky, and this is the first narrow part. Looks pretty neat. To all the travelers, pilgrims longing for a home, one who walks with. Well, we've just come out of the Narrows, and we've got to what looks to be the difficult section of the trail. And today we are going to turn around wisely, because we're by ourselves. And I don't think we could make that without a significant amount of assistance. The amazing thing about this trail is that there are tire marks on it. You can definitely see, and they go up this. That's just a little bit too gnarly for us today. Here's a panoramic view of the Calico Mountains. We've been driving on the trails around here for a little bit, maybe a half hour, over these multicolored mountains. Really bizarre. Really pretty. There's a truck down there.
Gorgeous colors.
Out of sky. And we are bringing our vacation to a close. This will be the last footage for the whole trip. Beautiful sunset with a little bit of rain. Leaving Barstow, coming up on a very beautiful sunset. There's our little sleeping doggy, our little tired mini dog. Minnie! There she is! Little doggy!
Hi, doggy!
Not home yet.
I'm not home yet. So let us journey.